Imagine if you're a diabetic and you can measure your blood glucose level using a laser rather than pricking your finger. Instead, the person can put their wrist in front of a laser to take the measurement. Princeton researchers are working to solve real-world problems in health, technology, and the environment. University research can have a meaningful impact on people's lives.
Right, so we're gonna look in the middle.
Mm-hmm. We developed new tiny semiconductor lasers that are engineered to emit light in a very special way that we can use to detect chemicals for applications in the environment, in health, and security.
There's absolutely no sensation, so you couldn't feel anything.
Professor Gamakal is exploring new ways to use lasers to detect blood sugar levels in diabetics. A person could put a device, like a wristwatch, on their body that would continually measure their blood glucose level.
We do want to build technologies that serve people. So we look at society, we look at the environment and ask, you know, what are important questions to answer. Fields where there are open questions where one can have impact and kind of do good. On the other hand, I wouldn't be a real scientist if I wasn't also just motivated by creating something new.
Our researchers are also exploring ways in which humans can more effectively interact with computers. For example, Professor Verma and his team are developing technologies to make it easier for people to interact with computers or other electronic devices using hand gestures instead of typing on a keyboard.
But we should do an XY. So the technology that we're interested in creating, in some sense, really focuses on enabling interactions between electronics or computers and the physical world. A part of our research is really interested in enabling interfaces between humans and computers that are much more compelling. Possible applications for this technology are extremely wide and very diverse. In operating theaters, for hospitals, where surgeons, once again, in very constrained spaces, need to be able to interact with information that's being provided to them via a display. And things like gestures are very compelling ways for them to interact with this sort of information technology, because of course here we also face the constraint where infection can be transferred if surfaces are touched while a surgeon is engaged in some surgery. And in some sense, these are applications that we didn't really think of when we started working on this technology, but which are now sort of coming to surface.
All of these projects involve students doing basic research. For example, students in Professor Kang's laboratory are studying a gene that is involved with the spread or metastasis of cancer.
One of the research efforts that we have been doing in the past 10 years is to find out what kind of tumors are aggressive based on their molecular features. And more importantly, find the driver genes that make those tumors aggressive. Because that's the first step toward treating them. So in the end, we are not able to tell the patient whether they have a bad tumor, but furthermore, we can tell them that even though they have a bad tumor, we have a way to treat them, to stop them from spreading.
The thing that separates us from other institutions is our world-class faculty and researchers. This is about research that can benefit society.